New Orleans is no longer safe to live.
Hurricane Katrina roared toward the Gulf Coast.
This deteriorating situation in the city of New Orleans.
Alright, person transmitting the Mayday. Where are you?
Underwater. Here in New Orleans tonight, after the giant storm came the rising waters. Over 80% of the city is flooded.
It's unbelievable how many homes are just underwater, up to the windows some places, up to the roofs and others. Unbelievable.
Now this is the famous convention center, where the poorest of the poor, the old and the sick, about 15,000 people in all, were holed up when Hurricane Katrina hit town.
15 to 20,000 people over at the convention center is bursting at the seams.
I can see daylight out of the roof of the Superdome.
So there's minimal lighting, there's no air conditioning, and it's just a matter of time before you lose water pressure. And you have, 15 to 20, 25,000 people eventually in your building using the restroom with no water pressure. You can imagine what that's like.
Let them walk out of here. Let them walk away from the fill. Let them walk away from the devastation. Let them walk away from the dead bodies in here.
Summer has come and passed. The innocent can never last. Wake me up when September ends.
Oh, he's got a whole family there.
Like my father's come.
And then lower Ninth Ward, probably the hardest hit area in New Orleans now.
September ends.
We came back, I guess, about 10 days after the storm. We got back on campus. It was just total devastation.
I would never think that you'd have 8 foot of water, 9 foot of water, 10 foot of water on this campus.
It completely shocked me. Just took your breath away, like completely.
Just to come back and not be able just to go in and see everything nice and like it was before, it was tough.
That was a point where I really had to lean on my faith.
You know, these buildings, yeah, they mean a lot, but it's the people here that meant more. The teachers, the administrators, the faculty, you know, those I would consider my family, just as well as the students, because not only do they educate us, but they teach us stuff for the rest of our life.
I could almost feel him speaking to me, saying, you have to continue the mission. You have to continue the mission in New Orleans.
I just felt like so sad that like all this happened to such a great school, and like where so much history was here and so much good tradition. It just sucks that it had to happen to us, like our high school.
The teachers battled it out with us. The teachers were there when we were there. The teachers gave us a shoulder to cry on.
All you could do, all I could do, was think, where do we start?
The board really took a very serious, hard look at do we try to repair or do we look for a new location?
It's going to be fun. Start some new traditions. Bring back some of the old ones.
It doesn't make any difference where you are. It's the people you're with. We were Holy Cross in Baton Rouge. We were Holy Cross at Cabrini. We're Holy Cross here. We walk hand in hand. Now we're going to be Holy Cross at 5500 Paris Avenue at the Cabrini site. Because what we're carrying with us is a philosophy of education for our founder. The mission that he gave us, we're carrying with us.
We're facing a time where we need to be reminded of who we are, what this school is, what we're believing for, and that it's not going away.
We educate the mind, body, heart, and soul. We take care of the heart and the soul. That's very important to us. We have not deviated one iota from the mission of Holy Cross Education. How our students treat people, how they treat each other, how they treat the faculty, that has never changed and it will not change. And I would challenge them to do whatever they can to make sure that continues. We shall overcome somehow.